Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to the Super Mario 3D All-Stars Collection. We've played through Super Mario 64, we've played through Super Mario Sunshine. It is now time for us to play through Super Mario Galaxy. But let's go ahead and actually give ourselves some Galaxy music first. Egg Planet. That's good. That's good music. Alright, Super Mario Galaxy released November 12th, 2007 on the Wii. It's the night of the Star Festival, and star bits are falling from the sky. As everyone celebrates, Bowser suddenly appears and lifts the castle and Princess Peach into space, leaving Mario stranded in orbit. It's here that Mario meets meets a curious star child, Luma, and a mysterious woman in blue. This game introduced new ways to control Mario, like pointing and shaking the Wii remote, as he explores miniature planets with fun forms of gravity. Let's do this. Ooh. We got dabbing ice Mario on the loading screen, heck yeah. Oh my god, it has been a while since I played through Galaxy. Admittedly less time than it's been since I played through the other games, but... well, on the channel at least. We last played Super Mario Galaxy back on the Wii in 2015, so it's still 7 years ago. That's crazy. That is crazy. Now, I'm playing with two Joy-Con. You can also play with a Pro Controller or in handheld mode. Handheld mode allows you to have a touchscreen and like actually touch things on the screen. But with Joy-Con, it's much like Pikmin 3 Deluxe. We hit R, and now I have a pointer. It's controlled by the Joy-Con's gyro. If it gets messed up, I hit R again and it goes back to the middle. And I imagine it's going to mess up. You can already see it jumping a little bit, but anyway. Let's jump in here, create a file on planet number one right here, and this is the four icons we get. Back on the Wii, you could have your Mi be an icon, but unfortunately that's not the case here. I'm gonna go with Toad, because why not? Why not? I want to be a Toad planet. And there he is, big boy himself. You can also just change the icon whenever you want. And yes, it is 2022. Spoiler alert, that's how far ahead I'm recording this. Anyway, let's jump in.
Every 100 years, a comet appears in the skies above the Mushroom Kingdom. The comet was so large one year, it filled the skies and sent countless shooting stars raining down. The Toads brought the shooting stars to the castle, where they became a great power star. It should have been a very happy time for the citizens of the Mushroom Kingdom. That was the night of the Star Festival, held once every 100 years to celebrate the comet.
Dear Mario, I'll be waiting for you at the castle on the night of the Star Festival. There's something I'd like to give you. From Peach.
Mario seems pretty excited to go see his girl, because why the heck wouldn't he? Let's go on our way to Princess Peach's castle. Are you collecting star bits? I am. That's what these little things that are falling down from the sky are. If we point our pointer at them, no matter how far away they are, we can collect them. Which is pretty freaking cool.
Creation of my new galaxy. This festival's over!
I don't know where Bowser got an entire UFO from, but okay, the princess is this way. Thank you, Toad. I kind of gathered that much. Oh god, Peach, I'm coming, don't you worry. I could walk the long way around the path, but no, I'm running across your grass. I'm sorry, Peach. I have to in this situation.
Enjoy your flight!
Finally, you're awake! Let's play!
Okay, I'm down to play. You can already see how jumpy this Joy-Con is, my god. I'm not even that far away from my Switch, and it's like, yeah, no, we're gonna jump around. Get back here, bunny rabbit!
Let's play hide and seek. If you catch all of us, we'll tell you about where you are.
Alright, let's catch these bunnies. I wonder where they could be. In here, perhaps? I found a bunny! And something that the game's gonna teach is that I will teach you guys right now is if you hit ZR, you'll shoot a star bit and you can use them to hit these bunnies and slow them down. But, didn't really work there, did it? Also,
you caught me! Yeah, if only I'd hidden in the pipe.
The pipe, you say? And where might this pipe be? This pipe? Is it this one? Get in there, Mario. Bro? Okay. Oh, there's a bunny rabbit. Come here.
Get back here, you bunny.
Grab these star bits. And then hit you with them. Oh, there we go. Got him.
You caught me!
I sure did. Oh, that's a nice roof.
I should have hidden in the grass.
The grass, you say? Now, where might the grass be? You know, they kind of snitch on their friends. They're not the greatest at hide and seek. They're like, oh, I should have hidden in one of the three places that we usually hide when playing this game. There's the grass. And this bunny is a little bit further away, so hit you with that and gotcha.
I can't believe I let myself get caught!
Well, you did.
Wow, you caught all of us. Maybe you really can help Mama.
Thank you.
don't know if, you know, being able to catch three bunnies in a game of hide and seek is evidence enough that I can help your mother, but we shall see. I've been watching you from here. This place is called the Gateway to the Starry Sky. My name is Rosalina. I watch over and protect the cosmos. To save your special one, you'll need the power to travel through space. Luma can give you this power. I will entrust you with his care. You have the ability to spin now! Shake the Joy-Con! You can also spin with Y. Disaster has struck us, just as it has visited you. With Luma, I hope you can rescue the Grand Stars. May the stars shine down on you. Okay, bye, Rosalina. Nice to meet you.
Shake the thing or press Y to spin into things that look breakable. You can even spin enemies to stun them.
I like this addition. In 3D All-Stars, you don't have to shake your wrist about. You can just hit Y. It's incredible. Let's go. Over to our first planet, I suppose, besides the one we were just on.
Hi there. Good to see you. I have some bad news, though. See, I had a launch star all ready for you, but a meteor smashed it up. You can't leave without it, so find all the star chips to fix it. Oh, and be sure not to fall in the black hole.
Yeah, that'd be a pretty terrible start to this playthrough, wouldn't it? Falling into the black hole in the middle of this, planet. So Super Mario Galaxy, as I'm sure you've already noticed, is very, very different in terms of, like, gameplay and looks compared to the previous ones. Also, you got one additional Mario. Very nice. For one, our view is very, well, Mario's upside down, or like we're looking at the back of his head and he's upside down, he's going around these planets. You've got to get kind of used to the camera in this game. It's all over the place, but in my opinion, it works really well. It does work really well.
Get me out of here! One of those enemies should have the key. You can shake the thing or press the thing to make it spin around, dizzy, stun, run in. Yes! Okay, got it. Where are you at?
I'm going to assume that one of these things is not like the other, and it's probably this Goomba. Bonk! Sure enough, he had the key. I don't know how that Goomba held that key, he has no hands. But good for him.
Thanks! Would you mind rescuing my buddy in that base up there too? I'll transform into a Sling Star, just jump into me after I... TRANSFORM!
Alright! Let's go! I see the buddy up here. How you doing there, my guy?
Spin enemies, then run into them when they're stunned to boot them.
Yep, I shall, or I'll just spin into this instead. I still kind of instinctively, like, shake, even though I don't have to anymore, because it's muscle memory from playing the Wii version. You'll probably see me doing both throughout this playthrough, to be completely honest with you. Alright, let's go back down this way. I want to grab- aw, the star bits disappeared. No biggie. Down the pipe. Or not, because there's a Luma in the way. Hello?
Hurry! Down here! I'm trying, you're in the way!
You were so in the way, my guy.
We've been waiting for you. That's a Grand Star. We have to save it! They're using the Grand Star to power that awful machine. It looks like it's making something. We have to do something before the Grand Star's power is drained. Quick, find a way to stop that terrible machine.
I will do my best. I'm going to assume these buttons probably have something to do with it. So one and two. Excuse me, Goomba. Three and four. And then we'll go down here and hit these buttons.
Turn off the flip switches on the floor to shut down this machine.
Buddy, you're already here. Can't you do it? Or are you too light? Are you made out of literal, like, floaty stuff? Alright, there it is. What do you want, huh? You threatened? Ah, that's what you get. Let's collect our first Grand Star. You got a star! Grand Star Rescue from Gateway Galaxy. High score of 5 coins, and we increased our star bit count, and discovered a new galaxy. And my cursor's all over the place.
The beacon is lit again! It shines weakly, maybe only as bright as a Class 6 star, but at least the poor Lumas will survive now.
Oh, thank you for saving the Grand Star. These star people are my family. They mean so much to me. Welcome to the Comet Observatory. It's my home, and also home to the Lumas. You see, we travel the starry skies. We pass by this area once every 100 years, but we suddenly stopped in front of this planet. A strange force had latched onto our ship, pulling away star bits and our power source, power stars. Our ship had lost power, so it entered a deep hibernation state in which it could not move. Those who took your special one picked up the power stars, and discovered the power to cross the universe.
Please,
I have a request. This observatory uses star power to project images of the galaxies that are scattered across space. And there is a chance we can use our few remaining stars to look for other power stars. These round rooms are called domes. We observe galaxies from domes such as these. But the only one that is working now, powered by the star power you restored, is this one, the Terrace. Please go to the Terrace and try to recover the power stars from galaxies you can see from there.
If we do that, we'll be able to restore the Comet Observatory's ability to fly like a starship. Then perhaps we can pursue the thieves who ran off with the power stars.
Alright, we have our mission. We have our goal. Let's do this thing, shall we? Let's go to the Terrace and see what's going on in there. This first episode may be a bit longer than what the general episode time we've been aiming for in other series, but that's not a big deal.
Welcome! This dome acts as an eye of the observatory. From here, we can gaze upon distant galaxies. Once this Luma transforms into a pole star, it'll guide you to those faraway galaxies. Simply point your thing at the pole star and press A. If you lose sight of the thing, you can reset it with R. If you're playing in handheld mode, you can just tap the thing directly on the screen. Transform!
There we go. He has transformed into a little teeny tiny pole star. Hello.
These are the galaxies that can be observed from this dome. The numbers represent their distance from the observatory. The bigger the number, the greater the distance. The more power stars you find, the farther you'll be able to travel.
So, we only have one star, so we can only really go to this place right now. The Good Egg Galaxy.
Yes, it's undeniable. We're detecting power star energy patterns in the nearest galaxy. But I must warn you that the evil energy readings are off the charts. Please be careful.
I'll do my best, my guy. Let's go to the Good Egg Galaxy.
Now just wait for you to hear this music. It's incredible.
Star number one, Dino Piranha. Let's go. See what I mean? The soundtrack in this game is like entirely orchestrated, I think that's the word, And it's phenomenal. It's a beautiful soundtrack. I'm also trying to do one of these.
Damn it.
Do a little wall jump off of the building. And then a spin, and then you can go- Oh my god. Okay, one more go. Spin, move back. We're not going in that pipe today, folks. All that's in there is a one-up, so we're not gonna worry about it. But we can go up there eventually, maybe. Hello there, Mr. Luma. How are you doing today? To pick up star bit- Yeah, I know. I know. Handheld mode, you can tap them. 50 to get a one-up. It wouldn't hurt to source them up. Yep, okay. And that Luma makes a very good point. You are gonna- Okay, if this thing could work. You see how much is jumping around? My Switch is literally right next to me. I don't know why it does this. Anyway. It's gonna be a good idea to pick up as many of these as you can, because, you're gonna need them later in the game, I'll say that.
My friends are ahead, hurry!
I will! But I'm not gonna use your Sling Star, because I can do this. Eh. Yep, little shortcut. You don't actually have to talk to that Luma if you don't want to. Which I always thought was kind of interesting. Alright, we've got more star chips to collect. No biggie, I can pull that off. There's three. Let's maybe not get hit by these weird jello rocks. Well, I always called these, like, jello rocks because that- the red bit looks a bit like jello, but at the same time, it also looks like glass, which I think is what it's supposed to be. You can also spin into them to break them and grab star bits, which is, pretty cool. Good way to get some, a good amount of star bits right at the start here. If you so desire. Mario, stop spinning around in circles. I have to figure out some solution. I have to figure out what causes my Joy-Cons to disconnect like this. Because I'm literally like 3 feet away from my Switch. And it does it with every Joy-Con. It's not just this pair. So I really don't know what's happening. Alright, let's spin. We got a 1-up right there, which is great. What do we got over this way? Disappearing platform. Excuse me, sir. What are you hiding in your pipe? Where could this pipe even lead to? Like, looking at that, where could that have even gone? Just into the bottom of the little planet right there? I guess it is called a warp pipe, but technically, judging by clear pipes in other games, like, you do kind of have to have a destination in mind, you know? Like, it follows a line, if that makes sense. Stop spinning, Mario, my god. Okay, alright, we just... Oh, we're skipping past the planet we're on, okay. Ah, what are you? I see you there. Don't think I don't. Ah, yeah, give me your star bits. I kind of used a few trying to stop you and it didn't work, so give me those back. Hello. These right here are Octogoombas, or... No, Octoomba, I think is its full name, full official name. Or Octogoomba, both works. They go down just like a regular Goomba. Well, give me those star bits. Meow. Well, this seems mighty interesting. Mighty suspicious. Let me just grab a few of these star bits from the surrounding area before I do anything. I am going to assume that we need to hit this big bulbous tail. This is Dino Piranha, folks, and he's honestly incredibly easy. Just spin into his tail 3 times. Oh, he gets mad after the first hit. He gets super mad after the first hit. And then he starts chasing you just a little bit faster, but he's kind of an idiot, and you can just run around him like this, spin into his tail, and he's done. Definitely not the smartest piranha out there. Is he considered a piranha plant, or is he like... Well, he's dino piranha, but like, piranhas are plants. Piranha plants. That's a question for another day. We got a power star. Woohoo! Alright, another power star is in the bag. Technically, the grand star also counts as a regular power star, so it gets put on our total right there. Let's go ahead and save our game. And we are gonna- oh, okay. Those star bits are star bits. To Lumas, they are the tastiest, most delectable treats imaginable. Aim your thing at the screen and point your thing at them to pick them up. If you're playing in handheld- yeah. I'm pretty sure you've already talked about this, but Or someone's already talked about it. But he's gonna teach us about Starbits. Why don't we try it out? Aim at me? Buddy, I've already been using these. You don't have to teach me. There you go. Have those Starbits.
Mmm, tasty. Let's call those little morsels my fee for this lesson. You can also shoot them at enemies or feed them to a hungry Luma. Either way, I'm sure Starbits will help be a big help on your adventure. Okay, bye now.
Bye-bye, buddy. We're gonna head out here, and we are gonna call it an episode there, folks. And next time on Super Mario Galaxy on the Super Mario 3D All-Stars Collection, we'll continue exploring the terrace, probably more good at Galaxy. Oh, we're in first-person view now. Okay. Also, look how Mario turns into like a ghost when you do this. It's weird. Anyway, we're gonna do some more Good Egg Galaxy, get some more Power Stars, and yeah, that's that. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.